So this time what we will do is, let's talk about the algo. We will say, hey, generate binary pattern of size n. This is what we are doing. And that we will generate using helper function. So we will call it, let's say, approach 3. We'll still pass array a and n. We'll talk about why we are still passing binary pattern. And we are also passing which position of binary pattern we are filling first. So let's go ahead and say this int array a int n binary pattern and bi. So this is binary pattern index. But when we are filling index bi, we have two choices. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead with i0, i less than 2, i plus plus. And what choices we'll fill is binary pattern. First I'll fill 0. So I can also say this is binary index we want to fill. Fill the choice 0 first. So I is actually giving us choice 0, 1, 2. So I'll fill 0 first. Make a recursive call for a n bin p as it is and pi plus 1. We are saying fill the next position. Once that recursive call comes back, it will go and go with the next choice and go to the right side. Right. So this is how we are going about generating it. Now when do we print the binary pattern? If bi becomes equal to n, that's where we print binary patterns. Now here if you see, we will not be printing binary pattern, we will actually be printing array. That's the reason we passed array here. So what I can do is I can say for int I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Printing is where the trick is. I'll print percent t, and this percent d will be the array, not the binary pattern. So what I'll do is I'll say if bin p of I is 1, if that is the case, if it is 0 we don't print anything, if that is the case we print a of I. So based on the binary pattern we are printing the value, right? So once we print this, after that we'll give a new line and then we will return back from here, right? So see, we are not printing the binary pattern, we are just printing the array element. So this approach, if we take using binary pattern approach, when we generate binary pattern of 000, it will not print anything, it will just print a new line. When we print binary pattern of 001, it will print the last element 3, because only that element will be 1 and that element will be printed. Right. So let's go ahead and try to run this code. So we compile and run. First empty line is telling this is empty set, then it is 3, 2, 1, 3, 1. 1, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. And it all depends on the order in which we are filling. Ideally, if we would have filled this from the other direction, greater than equal to 0, first we are filling 1 and then we are filling 0, we would have got the subsets in reverse order. Because first left choice that we are making now the left choice we are making is fill and right choice we are filling is leave. So let's go ahead and draw it once. So you will see just order will get reversed. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, and 3. Right. So this is our approach 3 for generating subsets, where what we have done is we have generated just the binary patterns and we are generating our subsets using that binary pattern. So this is the recursive approach for printing the subsets with approach 3.